Hello again. We're back here at Comics Toons N Toys for Comic Book Day. It's been a blast here, and I got my buddy here, Andrew. Andrew, say hi. Say everybody.
How you doing out there?
So, Andrew, for Comic Book Day, what did you end up picking it up today?
Oh, you know, I got this shark book here.
Deadliest Sharks?
Sharks and a little bit of Avatar there.
Always a good pick. Nice.
Some Avatar going on. Rounded it up with Gadget.
Inspector Gadget.
Got some other stuff, yeah.
Some solid stuff.
Pretty good stuff, yeah.
Like your taste.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm John.
John? So, what'd you get today for Comic Book Day?
I got some more of the classics, you know, Misadventures of Adam West.
Nice, dude.
And just some other things like, you know, keeping up to date with the new movies. Yeah. Or
anyone you're looking forward to in particular?
Captain America.
Yeah?
Really, Captain America. I'm a big World War II fan. So kind of the cartoony World War II thing.
Basically, the whole reason for Free Comic Book Day, it's kind of like
to generate interest in the shop and in
comics. Yeah, I mean, it's kind of the same mission statement that San Diego Comic Con used to have, where it's to interest people into reading, and that's one of the big things that obviously, you know, other countries say, oh, America's illiterate and stuff like that. But it's things like Free Comic Day that, you know, get people to start reading. And the books that come out are just incredible. Like, and you have a Lock and Key book, you have an amazing Spider-Man book. I mean, yeah, like, all these books are really well written, and there's books for every age. And, I mean, that's what I love about Free Comic Day, first and foremost, is that it encourages reading. And that's one thing that's important.
It's ultimate escapism. It's, you know, you could do anything in comics.
Break the fourth wall.
Oh, absolutely, man. I mean, it's just an amazing medium to work in. And although it doesn't get the credit it deserves, if you really think about it, all the directors and stuff that are working right now, they have a love for comics in some way. And I think that kind of, you know, helped our big comic book movie boom nowadays.
Yeah.
You know, it was... Before it was like, oh, you know, don't tell anybody I read comics, you know? And now it's like, yeah, I totally read comics. I have every issue of Spider-Man, you know, dating back to, you know, Ditko years. I mean, you know, these are guys that are making Oscar, you know, award-winning films.
Yeah, like fully reputable kind of thing.
Totally, you know, and that's helping us, and the things that people in the industry do have even more credibility. Yeah, I just love it.
I've been doing comics since 1987. And I've gone into other areas and then come back. I've worked on video games extensively, worked in magazines and newspapers, things like rock videos, movies, and stuff like that. And comics is, you know, to me, the most addictive of all of the creative process. Part of it is just the ability that it's the closest thing to, you know, DIY entertainment that you can get these days. You know, someone with a good story and talent, and you know, paper and a pen or a computer and an art program can really not only tell their own story, but unlike it was back in the 80s when you were trying to get distribution, you know, because of the web, you know, you can pretty much instantly reach a worldwide audience. It's much more complex than that, but it's definitely the purest form of creative and artistic communication with your audience, without it being designed by committee or art by committee or story by committee. And that's incredibly satisfying when it works, you know, and it really puts the pressure on you as a creator to deliver the goods. You know, you can't make an excuse of like, oh, I was only the third eyelash modeler on the lead characters, so if it's crappy, it's not my fault.
I just love seeing this character that I've created in my mind just come out into the paper and have a life of his own, and it's always been a passion of mine. I've read comics since I was little. I've copied down like Spider-Man and everything onto paper, and I figured it was time to try and put something together.
I just loved them, and so I wanted to do them. And
simple enough.
Yeah, it's really. I was like, man, I have some cool ideas. And really, the funny thing was, I had this idea for stuff, and I was telling my friend about it. And for my day job, I'm a game design producer, and so normally I was just like, oh, I have this cool idea and I kind of want to make it into a game, but that takes forever. And a friend of mine was like, why don't you just make a comic out of it? I'm like, genius! So that's what I did. And that's how I met her, because she works at a company that I worked for doing concept art. So.
And what is it that brought you into comics? There's no
money. Same thing. It was harder to find when I was a kid, but when I found them, I was just like, oh, there's drawings and they're blowing stuff up. Yeah. And I was just really excited. I got it. I was like, all right.
The most pleasure I get out of it is interacting with other artists, as well as interacting with fans of the characters that I draw. I tend to draw a lot of fan art, and so I get a lot of appreciation for drawing certain characters, and I like the feedback that I get from the people that appreciate my art.
I've always loved drawing as a little kid. Earliest memories were of drawing, and other early memories were of superhero cartoons and toys.
Oh, yeah?
Having Batman toys, Superman toys, they were just there. I don't remember them being introduced. It was just Mom, Dad, Superman, Batman. They were just in the house. So just, just kind of was like born into superheroes and comics. My dad was a comic collector when he was a kid, though he didn't pursue that as an adult. But, you know, I just remember superheroes being around and just really enjoyed the bright colors and the costumes of you know, especially the 1970s and 80s comics when I was a kid. So that was the first things that really started to attract me was the larger than life stories and powers and characters, you know, the alter egos and stuff, the mystery behind that. So those were some of the initial things that kind of were there right at the beginning of my life. Yeah, so there was no way to get away from it.
When I was really, really young, like about 3 or 4, my mom would draw Green Lantern or Flash or Batman for me, you know, and so I could color them in. And I got tired of waiting for her because she had this annoying thing called a job, you know, that was taking up time. And I'm like,
it's a job.
I'm like, come on, there's superheroes to be colored. So, you know, I out of sheer necessity, I started drawing them myself, it's what I've always wanted to do.
I started drawing when I was really little. Everybody has a story. I'm, you know, about 5 years old, and I used to draw from coloring books. I loved cowboys, and I would draw cowboys and stuff, and cartoons from, you know, TV shows. My first introduction was, you know, Spider-Man. Yeah, on TV. And I didn't know that there were comics. And one day, you know, I went to 7-Eleven, and I don't know if you guys remember, they had the spinner racks.
The spinner racks.
Oh, yeah, me too. I would spend my whole allowance on spin racks. Okay, so I would go in, and the first comic that I really thought, like, this is really cool, was West Coast Avengers. And this was in the mid-80s. And, you know, I would just collect. I would just collect anything and everything, independence, whatever. And I think it wasn't until, I don't know, like 89, 90, where I was creating my own comics just for fun because, you know, I wanted my own adventures. I had my own characters already before I got into comics, but comics is the one that made me say, this is the medium I want to show them in. But yeah, I would say late 89, 90, I thought, I could do this. You know, I was horrible.
And you are doing it.
Well, yeah, it took a while. You know, I had a few sidesteps. You know, I was interested in acting and a bunch of other stuff. But comics was a constant in my life. And I just came back to it and said, this is it. You know, I planted my feet, and that was it.
That's great. I love it.